Well, have you ever wondered why your local station newscasts, newscasters, all seem to get along so well together? Why they smile so much? Why they do the kind of news stories they do? It may be because someone, such as our next guest, advised them to be that way.
He is Al Primo, founder of Primo News Service, a firm which specializes in consulting with TV stations and recruiting people for anchor and top producer jobs in TV news departments.
Al Primo generally is credited with having invented the Eyewitness News type format at one of its most successful users, WABC-TV in New York. Al Primo, thank you for joining us today, and we'd like to remind our viewers as we welcome you that you'll be happy to take, well, at least you'll be... will take their phone calls in just a few minutes. We'd like to begin with a look at what a consultant can do for a television news station's news department. You provided some tape to us. We'd like to look at part one. This is before Al Primo came along to this TV station. And if we can, let's roll the tape, and then you can tell us what we've seen and how you changed it, all right?
The Late Edition with Jack Williams, Liz Walker, Chris Maroon, Bruce Schwegler, and Bob Lobel.
Coming up on the Late Edition, the White House has a change of heart about striking controllers.
And in these final lazy days of summer, why not take advantage of the perfect weather?
Well, that is a good question. What will weather be like down in Newport or Wise One?
Well, it looks like there's going to be some cloudiness arriving here over the weekend.
Have a nice weekend.
Okay, Al Primo, what was wrong with that, as you see it?
Well, there was really nothing dramatically wrong with it. The point that we were trying to get accomplished here when you're going to see the new look for this particular television station was that just visually that this was a station that has been serving the Boston community for years and had not had, in our opinion, a developed look and a look that was able to allow the television station to take full advantage of the technology available to it, live remotes, videotapes, satellite reports. There was no way to bring that material into the set and through the set to the audience in a way that the audience could really relate to it. It was a rather simple set, a clean set, but all the additional material that the station was generating just seemed to come to the audience in a way that that appeared like magic. And what we tried to do is to recommend this kind of a set that you're going to see that not only maintained a similar look, but had the capability to demonstrate the television station's ability to communicate information by satellite, live, etc.
All right, fine. Now, we've seen what they did before, and you've explained a bit what your goals were. Let's take a look at at the new look, and then we'll find out about that.
Okay, fine.
Live from New England Satellite News Channel, the one news team that captures the pulse of the news, Jack Williams, Liz Walker, John Henning, Bob Lobel, and Bruce Schwegler. This is Eyewitness News, the evening edition.
Good evening. Here's what's happening. It's countdown time for the men who want to be governor of Massachusetts. The final full day of campaigning is nearly over.
The big question to be raised tonight is, will it be King or Dukakis? Will it be Sears, Card, or Lakian?
And today, tonight, we're going to be showing off some new technical wizardry, oh wizard.
I hope we are. We've got a lot of action on our weather map, both here, far to the east, and far to the west. But locally, here's what the action is right now.
Remember, when the news happens tonight, we'll be there. Have a nice evening, and thank you for watching.
Good evening, everybody. Primo, a lot of pizzazz there and a lot of monitors in the background. What function do all those monitors serve besides just visually looking like television?
Well, as you well know, being a person who is on the air, to have the opportunity to see the source of video as it's about to be presented to the audience is a great help and gives you and gives the anchor person the confidence of knowing that the material is going to be there. It does give you a presence and more confidence so that the audience, which is depending on you to deliver the information, has a sense that you know what you're talking about, you know where the material is coming about. And that's really the purpose of all those monitors.
But the anchor person can't see all the monitors that are behind him or her. The two weather people were standing up there, or an anchor and a weather person were standing next to something that said radar, but...
Well, there are 13 monitor banks there with 38 television sets, and as you might imagine, there aren't 150,000 sources of video, so some of those monitors contain the material in front of them. It's, in other words, a replication of the video that's in the back is also in the front of them so that they can see it. Mm-hmm. But the whole idea there, and what we were trying to accomplish there, is to have a look that was more representative of WBZ in television. This is the station in Boston that had been there the longest. This is the station that has been the most stable station for years, the news leader, and was suddenly challenged by Channel 5 and faced the immediate prospect of a more severe challenge by the new operators of Channel 7. And so that the idea there was to make absolutely certain that the viewers of Boston television understood that WBZ was, in fact, the dominant station and had the capability to do the news as good as, certainly, but probably better than its competitors.
Why is it so important that the the anchor team seem to be having such a marvelous time about it all?
Well, I don't know that that's necessarily important. That particular tape was a first night tape. We don't, I just as a news consultant, as a longtime news person, we have a great deal of respect for journalism, and I think that that is the critical and crucial part of any news program.
Well, I wanted to ask you about that. We didn't see any of the substantive changes because it's hard to show them in a short time.
Yes.
Tell us about the substantive change, not necessarily in this case, but what can you do for a station in making their news better as well as more palatable?
Well, I think that we have been able to demonstrate over a long period of time that what really is effective and what the viewer really wants is competent, comprehensive information. Better information than your competitors can get. And that is really a basic truism of journalism. And if the station that practices the best journalism and takes care of all of the visual accompaniment, the set, the graphics, the station that does that best is the station that will ultimately be the dominant television station in the market.
Al, why is there such an apparent antagonism between many news people and news producers and consultants? A lot of news people, anchor people, producers say, oh no, don't bring in the consultants, and the news, the station managers will go get the consultants. Even the networks use consultants. So tell me, why is there that antagonism and hostility?
Well, to be perfectly brutally honest with you, the news consulting business has had its share of charlatans, quick fix artists, and all the rest of it. And I say that from the basis of being a longtime journalist and news director, and part of the reason, as a matter of fact, the reason that I decided to get into this important work was because that most of the field was peopled by research-only kinds of consultants. People who really had no background in journalism, people who did research surveys and then would interpret those results from a non-news point of view. And that extended itself to the point where they hired consultants to go visit the stations, and usually the consultants that they hired were people with no significant news training. I mean, we believe as a company, and I believe personally, that if you're going to send a news consultant into a television news operation, that particular individual better be a very accomplished, seasoned veteran of what news and journalism is all about. And that person also has to have the ability to understand modern graphics and modern visuals as well.
We'd like to talk about one of your other major functions, which is as a talent scout, finding employees for employers. And our viewers will want to call in, so let's take a break, Al, if you will, and hang on with us for just a minute, and we'll be right back.
Fine.
The number to call if you have a question for Al Primo or a comment is 404-898-8550. As usual, please keep your questions short so that we can get a lot more of them in. We'll be right back.